Turn a fraction into a decimal, we know how to handle that. You just turn the denominator into a power of 10. Uh-oh. Powers of 10s only have 2s and 5s in their prime factorization. That's a 3. No matter what we multiply 3 by, we're going to get a number that has a 3 in its prime factorization. So we can't turn that into a fraction with a power of 10 as its denominator. We're going to have to figure out something else to do. Well, a fraction is just division. Let's try division. We're going to divide 3 into 1. Of course, 3 doesn't go into 1. We're going to need some tenths. 3 into 10 tenths, that's going to give us 3 tenths. And 3 times 3 is 9. That means we're going to have one of these tenths left over. 3 doesn't go into 1. We're going to need hundredths. Bring down the 0. 3 into 10 goes 3 times. And leaves us 1 left over. 3 doesn't go into 1. We need another 0. We need the thousandths. 3 into 10 goes 3 times. And we have 1 left over. This is going to go on forever. Each time we're going to go 3 into 10. It's going to go 3 times. It's going to have 1 left over. We're going to need another 0. We carry it on. This is never going to end. We just keep repeating the same steps over and over. So we're going to get a 3 and a 3 and a 3 and a 3. Oh, I don't want to write 3s forever. No, you don't want to watch me write 3s forever. So we're going to have a special notation that just means do this forever. Instead of writing 3s forever, I'm going to put 0.3. I'm just going to put a bar over the 3. And all that bar means is keep writing this over and over and over again forever. So 0.3 with the bar over it, that's 3 repeating. That doesn't mean 3 tenths. That means 0.33333333 on and on and on and on forever. So we have a nice notation for writing this decimal that continues forever. Let's try another one. All right, well, 22, that at least has a factor of 2 in the denominator, but it also has an 11. And there aren't any 11s in a prime factorization of a power of 10. So we can't just multiply this top and bottom by something and get a denominator that's a power of 10. We're going to have to divide again. We're going to take 22, divide that into 7. Well, 22 doesn't go into 7, so again, we're going to go to our tenths. 22 into 70, that's going to go 3 times. 3 times 22 is 66, so we have 4 left over. So we're going to have to bring down hundredths, because 22 doesn't go into 4. 22 into 40, that'll go once. 1 times 22 gives us 18 left over. 22 doesn't go into 18, we bring down another 0. 22 into 180. I know that 20 times 8 is 160. And then 2 times 8 is another 16. So that gives me 176. And that means we have 4 left over. Just like we did before. We had 4 left over before, so if we bring that 0 down, we know that's going to go in one time. And that'll leave us 18 left over, just like we had before. So if we bring down a 0 again, we know that 22 goes into 180. We've already done that. It's going to go in 8 times. Gives us 176, 4 left over, and on and on and on. We see this is going to repeat again and again and again. Once we had the 40 here, we hit the 40 again. We see that we're going to repeat over and over and over. We're going to go 1-8, 1-8, 1-8, 1-8, and that's going to continue forever and ever and ever. So we use our little notation again. We go 0.318, and here we have to be careful. A little bar we're going to put on there to say repeating. That just goes over the 1 and the 8. It doesn't cover the 3. If it covered the 3, that'd be 0.318, 318, 318, 318. But we just want 3, 18, 18, 18, 18. We only want the 1 and the 8 repeating. So we just put the bar over the 1 and the 8. And that's how we write 7/22 as a decimal. Let's try one more. So, that's a big denominator. Well, we could do long division, but this looks an awful lot like the last problem we just did. We can take out, we've got that 0 in the denominator. At the end, we can take that out as 1/10 times 7/22. And 1/10, well, we know how to write that as a decimal. That's just 0.1. And we already did this. We already did 7/22. We found that that was 0.318. And the 1/8 is repeating over and over and over. And when we multiply a decimal by 0.1, that's dividing by 10. All we're doing is moving the decimal point one place to the left. Move this decimal point one place to the left, and we get 0.0318. And again, the 1/8 is repeating over and over and over. So we've converted this fraction into a decimal. We didn't even have to do another long division. We just did a little bit of thinking. A little bit of thinking saved us a whole lot of work.